Welcome back. We're into our third segment right here on Off the Pitch. Desire, Derek Ford, Mugumisa is my name. Still sitting in for Charles Mutebi. Thank you for keeping it urban. Now, we're still hanging out with Charlotte Modola, who is the Lady Rugby Crane Sevens captain. And yeah, we're still talking a whole lot of rugby. Charlotte, before we went into that break, I hope you're still having a good time with us.
Yeah, I am. Very. Right. I'm enjoying myself.
This all right, just like hold this a little closer to you.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Great.
You know, it feels like we're having a conversation. That's why I'd even forgotten about the mic.
So yeah.
I'm actually having a good time. I've never had an interview like this where it's a conversation.
Yeah.
Free to say what comes to mind. So this is amazing and the first time for me, and I'm actually enjoying myself.
All right. Mr. Producer, the captain just said I deserve a bigger salary. I gave her the first of this kind of interview. Anyways, we've talked about a whole lot of your rugby life and your decisions and everything.
Yeah.
Let's talk about you away from rugby, for starters. Do you get to work? Like, do you have a 9 to 5 p.m. job, or is all the money earned out of rugby?
No. Actually, for me, rugby is a hobby. It's something I do because I love sport and I love rugby. But basically, I do have a job. I'm a lawyer by profession.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I work with...
Practicing?
No, actually, I work with Uganda Registration Services Bureau.
Okay.
I'm a senior registration officer and head of the poster office branch, one of our branches. So I manage and head the poster office branch.
So I
have a job from 8 to 5 p.m. Sometimes
8 to 5?
Sometimes I even exit to 6, so depending on how busy the office is.
So if I want Charlotte from Monday to Friday... It is poster that I get to find out, not at the rugby grounds.
And I'll be very busy. I may not even have time for you, so it will be a very hard, like, very hard to get me. So if you want to get me, maybe lunchtime. I can give you, like, 15 minutes, probably.
Yeah.
So I'm a very busy lady.
Oh, yeah. Clearly. And then, because rugby is your hobby, you're not looking at it as my weekends are robbed from me. The weekends are spent doing your hobby.
Yeah. If there are games, I actually do my hobby. Then if there are no games, I usually go to the gym. Sometimes I work out. Then sometimes if I want to rest, I use it to rest.
Okay.
Prepare for the new week.
All right. Yeah. With sport, I know it's not about the games on Saturday or Sunday. It's also about training. How do you manage to train? And yet the teammates are going to be training during the week. How do you get to do that?
Yeah, I usually communicate. You know, sometimes it's also important to communicate to your coach. So sometimes if I know that day I'm not going to make it in time, because if I'm not going to make it in time and I'll be late, I usually tell her, you know what, I'm held up at work, I'll be late, but I actually do make it for the training sessions. I do make it for the training sessions.
Yeah.
So it depends on, it's all about balancing and communicating to the coach. And
okay.
Yeah, but it does work out for me.
All right. And how often do you get to miss training in, say, a month, on average?
Right now, for example, National Team Sevens, we train on Saturdays and Sundays. So usually the training I do it during the week is usually my own personal training.
Yeah.
Or I go pick, I ask someone to help me, take me through certain workouts and certain things I really need to work on. Mm. So basically in a week, I can miss like sometimes twice, once a week, but I make an effort to make up. I do make up sessions.
Okay.
Also. Yeah. So I find a way to make sure I don't go backwards. I have to keep moving forwards and lag behind. I don't lag behind.
All right.
Yeah.
But you definitely would be a much better rugby player if all you did was wake up, breathe, think, eat rugby.
I think for all rugby players in Uganda, you know, if rugby was a professional sport in Uganda, I think, because there's a lot of raw talent in Uganda, and we're too athletic. If we had that opportunity to, you're only focusing on rugby, I think we'd be amazing players, everyone, not just me.
Yeah.
So yes, it would be, that would be the case.
All right.
Yeah.
Now let's get back to your workplace. Your workmates, do they know you are this huge in the rugby circles?
Yeah, they actually know I play rugby. Sometimes when like we have tournaments, they usually, actually most of them say, when you have a tournament in Kampala, make sure you let us know. Unfortunately, we haven't had tournaments here in Kampala, so I cannot invite them, but they are really interested and they're excited for me when something really big happens, even when I'm made captain.
Yeah.
You know, even after this achievement in Botswana, they're actually proud of me, because I'm not only representing Uganda, but even the office, and I make them proud. So yeah, they're really proud, and I'm really representing the office really well.
Do you think there are people who are paying more attention to rugby because, hey, my workmate is the captain of the Lady Crane Sevens?
I believe, yeah, because some of them had no idea what rugby was. So, yeah. But the moment they got to know me and they know, oh, we know someone who actually plays, now the interest came in. So, yeah.
Okay.
For some actually have been watching the rugby, the rugby games.
Okay, we had also women get to talk about how they are abused or sexually abused around office and stuff like that. I don't know, do you have that going on for you? Do you have people discriminating against you because, oh, she's a tomboy, she's not exactly a girl or something like that? Because there are people who think of sports ladies that way.
No, the thing is, the beauty about my office, there's zero tolerance for sexual abuse. They don't stand for it. And the second thing is, for them, they look at what you do, what you bring to the office. Mm-hmm. It's all about what are you bringing in, whatever they need in the office. You understand? Mm-hmm. We have core values. Do you follow the core values? It's about the work you do.
Yeah.
So they don't care about what you are, but they look at what you're bringing to the office. So, and I've been, like, they appreciate who I am and what I do, and they respect what I do and who I am. So, I haven't had any challenge with my workmates or my bosses at work.
Right, that's great.
Yeah.
How about growing up? Did you feel you were still taken for the lady you are when you started playing rugby in school among your peers and stuff like that? Or was there a little bit of, she's different?
No, actually, you know, the thing is, I'm a very friendly person. It's very hard to hate me. So I was just outgoing, down to earth, free spirit basically.
Whoever had the guts to bully you, you were already friends with them, so they couldn't do it.
Yeah, they couldn't bully me. And if you don't like me, well, it's your problem, deal with it. I'm not going to sulk and my life won't stop. So I'm more of a free spirit and no one would bully me. Mm-hmm. I would blend in easily because I can do sports, I could act, I could. Yeah. Basically, I think for me, I made sure I was in, I tried to be engage myself in everything and anything to like expand my knowledge on things and just what I can do. So I don't think I was bullied in school. I wasn't, I don't think, but I wasn't bullied.
Yeah.
I wasn't discriminated against. Not like, I had so many friends. It was so amazing for me in school.
Okay, let's talk about your talent and how you get to find yourself doing so many different things so well, more so in the sports circles. I don't know, but I feel like maybe sometimes it's a downside to it because I relate to it as a presenter, as a person within the media. I find myself in a position whereby I could present almost every show, maybe all the shows, but I don't want to commit to that. But I could study a show and adjust to it and be able to present it without a problem. I could produce a show without a problem. I could do so many things within television without a problem. And I feel like because of that ability, I found myself doing different shows for short spells of time, and because the session will feel like, I think we could use him here. We need someone to fill this gap. So you come in and stuff like that. And maybe, just maybe, I will feel sometimes like, maybe that hindered my growth. The viewers didn't get to see me on one project for 3 years or something like that. Don't you feel that could have been a hindrance for you as well, knowing that I can do so many different things, so maybe I will not concentrate so much on one thing?
I didn't look at it that way, actually. It was just about me trying out different things and enjoying myself. So actually, that's a good question because I've never actually sat down and thought about it in that angle. Yeah.
Lucky you, I've got to say. Lucky you.
I don't know. I've never actually thought about it, so I can't give you a concrete and straightforward answer about that. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I've got to say lucky you, because then we could have been stuck with Charlotte Modola, who plays basketball, football, rugby, and is also a sprinter. So you don't guess exactly.
I think, but it doesn't even make sense anyway. So I don't think it would have worked out for me.
Yeah.
I think I would have been just now wasted talent. Like, at some point, you're like, okay, what am I going to play?
Yeah, that was a very huge possibility.
You end up missing out at least on playing for a national team somewhere because you're busy playing this. Then you have work.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think, I've never thought about
it. It would have been crazy, I've got to say.
I've never thought about it because I knew I was like rugby and my work, and that was it.
All right. Yeah. What would you say have been your biggest strengths in 2 minutes?
My biggest, as an individual or as a rugby player?
As a rugby player.
I think it's discipline. There are many, actually. There are many.
just help us.
Okay, I'm a principled person. Disciplined, integrity, and hardworking.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Right. And a team player. Oh, that's a very important thing. I'm a
team player.
Yeah, very good team player.
So you will stay on the bench because you feel if another player gets on, they will offer more than you?
Well, you know, there's a way a coach can plan it. If the coach says, I'm putting this player for a certain number of minutes, then after, I'll bring you on to change and change everything, so be it. Because the coach,
you're okay with it?
Yeah, I'm okay. The fact is,
because you're seeing the bigger picture.
Yeah, I'm seeing the bigger picture and I'll still contribute in one way or the other to the team.
All right, Shalom, yeah. Thank you. to know that we still have another segment is huge for me because Shalom seems to be having so much to share with us. Unfortunately, I've got to start also apologizing that we won't be able to share everything because she has so much to talk about. We have so little time. We're going to be taking a short break. When we get back, let's go all personal with Shalom. We're going to be trying to find out who she is as a person away from rugby, what her strengths are, who are the special people in her life, and much more. Do stay tuned.